In this segment of the Word tutorial, I'm going to go over the process for performing mail merges using Microsoft Word. This takes place in having what's called a form in Word in conjunction with a list of customer data. In our case, the customer data is in Microsoft Excel, where we have a worksheet, and in the first row it has the field names, such as first name, last name, street address, telephone. We also have a field with comments for each customer. In our case, we want to perform a mail merge. To do that, we go to Mailings and then click on Select Recipients and then either create a new list or use an existing list, or you can use contacts from Outlook. We're going to use an existing list, which is the Excel data file, and this is what's best. In most cases, if your data is in an external database, you can export that data into Excel and then use it as part of a mail merge. To connect to the data, click here, Use a Data List, and then go to the folder that contains our data list. In my case, it's Customer List for Mail Merge. Double-click on it, and then click on Yes to this prompt. And next, we are prompted to filter the recipients for the mail merge. At this point, we're going to do letters, and then next, we need to insert the fields. To insert the field, go here to Insert Mail Merge Field, and then put their first name, and then it's going to say thank you for supporting, and then we need to put their name again. Put first name, a space, then last name, then the address, put the codes for the address. So the street address, space, the city, comma, the state, comma, and then the zip. To put the telephone number as well, click on Insert Field, and then pick the telephone field, and then email as well. If you noticed earlier in our data file, I don't have comments field for everyone. I have only for a couple of them. In this case, we don't put the label comments. We just insert the comments field in there. We could format this and then go here to preview the results. Click on preview the results and then view each customer. So press next, 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 and this is what it's going to look like. If we want to make any corrections, we could highlight certain areas, make it bold or whatever, and then it's going to apply that formatting to this form. Once we are ready to merge it, click here on Finish, and then click on Edit Individual Documents. I do suggest that you select Edit Individual Documents first instead of printing hundreds of those records only to find out that you need to make an adjustment. So if I click here on Edit Individual Documents, it's going to create one letter for each one of the customers that are in my list in Excel. So if I go to the beginning here, notice these are the comments and the data for each customer. But then if I go further down, notice we have 38 letters for this mail merge. If I go to the data in Excel, notice that I have 38 customers, one less than 39 because the first row is the customer names. So if everything looks good, then go ahead and press print. Typically, unless you want this for documentation purposes, there is no need to save the merged results document. So you technically, after you print it, you could close it and not save it. However, the form, you want to save it because once you open it in the future and you add a new record, you can always rerun it without having to do all the linking of this form to the data and the fields. So in this case, I'll say mail merge. And if I close it and go back to my data and I save the data, now if I open this document again and I click on yes, okay, it's going to link to the Excel file. And if I go to mailings and run the mail merge again, notice that the last record should include my new data that I entered in Excel, my own records for Kaceli Tech Training. And there it is. So you reuse the form, you save the form, and then open it up again so it relinks to the data, and then you generate the letters based on the data that is in Excel. If you go back to your form, you could filter your recipients by zip code or by state and so on, so that the new mailing will apply only to whatever those filter definitions are.